The Living Soap last week, we asked you, the viewers, to vote for who you thought should be our new housemates. 32,000 of you called in. Who did you vote for? Was it Sporty Annika, DJ Andy, Captain Debbie, Jez the Coach, Nadia the Model, or Mark the Medic? Stay tuned to find out.
Previously on The Living Soap, rumours about Karen's love life continued when Simon and Dan denied claims they'd sold the story to the papers.
Do you know what I mean? I wish I had sold the story.
All this trouble that's been caused by her thinking we had.
Oh, she's confused. She's been looking at too many art posts.
Colin's passion for partying continued as his 21st birthday celebration carried over into a second week.
Wow! Tequila jelly. And you're right to agree.
But eventually, even Colin was wasted and had to face the consequences. Colin may have felt like one of the living dead, but he wasn't feeling half as bad as I was last week. All of a sudden, the realities of university life hit me. There was no one around to tell me what to do or where to go anymore, and I felt really alone. Things were so much brighter in October when I came up to start university.
Okay, well, I'm a bit nervous, but nothing I can't handle.
Last week, my dreams turned to nightmares. I really didn't know what I was meant to do. I'd missed lectures and forgotten to register for my exams.
It's just I don't understand what I'm supposed to be doing and what's expected of me and the marking system and everything. It's all just completely out of my head. I don't like being at university. Because everyone else seems to know what to do. I haven't quite got the hang of it yet. I don't like being mediocre. And ever since I came here in October, I felt mediocre. I haven't quite sort of got my mind used to the idea that I'm at university. I still think I'm at school. And there's nobody here to tell me what to do and when to give things in. I haven't felt like I can do anything since I've been here. I've just felt like I'm just scraping by. And it's no one's fault but my own. So I don't really have any right to be upset about it, but.
At the Positivity fashion show rehearsals, Karen was taking all her problems in her stride, dealing with the publicity she'd been getting in typical fashion.
Tea break. Me. Ah! Don't I want half a galaxy chunk?
Yeah. Put it in my bag.
No, you're buying up
my bag. Oh my god, it doesn't have a calorie count in it. That's always really bad news.
You can't get any more out of the packet if you've never tried.
Yeah.
We want some kegs off, mate.
Dan getting kegs off.
Not to be outdone, Colin was rehearsing for a rival fashion show.
Not too many tips.
I know,
not
too
many.
That's
it.
Well, we should get someone to compare it, shouldn't we?
We need to find whoever it is, like, I mean, tomorrow.
Yeah. What about all the Coronation Street lot? I mean, can you imagine having the twins?
The twins.
Well, who are the twins?
I don't know. They're just. I've seen them a couple of times on the show.
Are they men or women?
Men. And they're quite cute.
Well, I don't. I never watch it.
I don't really watch it.
I don't know.
Mavis and Derek.
Really.
We're not having Mavis
apart
and Derek.
Apart from, like, well, I know who Bette Lynch is. She'd be quite funny, probably.
She's quite frightening.
Well, why don't we try out Richard and Judy as well? Just ring
right,
up
so we can
ring up lots of different people because there's no guarantee that anyone's going to say yes.
Well, what about certain members of your house that can help us with famous pop stars?
Like who?
Like maybe some members of Take That.
Yeah, Take That. Just have Take That as our compares. That would be so funny.
I don't know if Karen though would help us. Okay. I just think it's a shame that she was upset that we were also doing a fashion show.
The hunt for a celebrity compare was on. Who would the lucky person be? Someone else was in the limelight on Sunday night, Annika.
Pop round, thought we'd let you know that right. You won the vote this weekend.
Oh,
10,500.
Oh, boy.
So, don't tell your friends.
Yeah! My mum will probably go, oh, really?
Good, eh?
What the? Not bad. Actually, can I just say my finger's knackered by dialing my number all the time? No, I shouldn't. Hi, Lila. It's my sister. Well done. How many times did you ring? Yes, my mate Dave called me and went, way, way. She's the one with a big pair of boots.
which boy? Which
It's not just my university work that's been suffering lately. I'd been missing shifts at my part-time bar job and didn't really want to keep letting them down, so I decided to give it up.
Hi, is that Ryan? Hi, it's Spider. Hi, I'm just going to say that I really can't work tonight because I've promised that I'd go and see someone play in a band and I really have to go. And also, I really don't know whether I should carry on because it's not fair to you because I'm always putting you out by not being able to turn up. It's like a shame because I really enjoy it, but yeah. Okay, bye.
Spider, what are you doing? Spider.
Trying to sort my life out.
You're upside down.
Yeah.
So your thoughts are far more clear.
Hello. Pot noodle on floor. Hello.
Hello, do I care? Yes, you do care.
I'm just gonna go to sleep. Wake me up next year.
But look, there's a pot noodle on the floor.
I think what I need is a good paranormal disposition game to get it all out of my system.
Even though Matt had left the house, we still kept in touch, and I went along to give him and his band Paranormal Disposition some moral support. The Living Soap film crew, meanwhile, was making another house call to Dr. Mark.
You're good working, you're in the house.
Right. I don't know what to say.
Well, please, come here. Just lost the house, mate.
Yes!
I can only be a good thing. Sling it up.
He's all embarrassed.
Get it.
Mm.
When are you moving in? When are you getting out of my hair?
The public row between Dan, Simon and Karen had reached such a pitch that Karen decided it was best to leave the house.
She's very upset. She's not happy with what's going on and she's decided to leave. If that's what she wants to do, then I think she should. If it causes her nothing but anguish, then the best thing is to leave him and it's not the end of the world.
Another one, guys.
She's had enough and wants to go, which is a real shame, because I don't want her to leave.
I really don't want her to go, but there you go. It's her decision. Such a shame.
That was Karen.
Same.
You know she's moved out?
She's actually moved out?
Mm-hmm.
When?
Today.
Where has she gone to?
I don't know. She's moving into a flat somewhere.
I don't know. Who with?
By herself. And then we're having those new people probably coming in.
Have you chosen
them yet? No, it's not up to us to choose at all. It's up to the public. Anyway, Amanda.
What?
We've got to start doing...
I'm glad I came round. It's such an opportune moment, Colin.
Yes.
Because once again, you're making me do something.
How lucky.
Yes.
And you'll do it, Amanda.
Mmm. I'm a lawyer, not a barber.
We want it to be completely grade one so you can see my whole head, so basically you just use that. Just don't put a thing on it at all.
Completely grade one, are you
yeah,
sure?
I've done it before, Amanda.
I know, but you
can I just tell you what to do? You don't cut off any dreadlocks. Just do that, go... Ow. Do you understand what I want you to do? Wait, before you start. Amanda, just go up to here. You've got to talk to me about...
Is that right?
So do you want to own your own salon one day? That's what I always say.
Who'd you say that to?
My hairdresser.
Want to...
Ow! What are you doing? It's killing me. Get me a mirror. Get that mirror over there. It's not very amusing. You see. Look at diagram four, Amanda. Look! See, that's lovely now. I'm quite enjoying it.
Whoops! Oh, look. Dreadlock on the floor.
What? You are joking, aren't you?
Yes.
I can't believe you. Can you please do it properly?
I'm trying.
I know you're trying.
I haven't got a degree in hairdressing. Have I?
Quite clearly.
She's giving me a shock. Take it. Gave me a shock.
So, you're okay now. Go on, continue again. What am I looking at, Amanda?
Don't know, what are you looking at, Colin?
Hi. It's those again.
You're fascinated with those, Colin.
I am, actually. Oh, weird.
I think I've finished, Colin.
You want to show me the mirror?
That's okay.
Can we look at the back?
How is it?
You've done it really well, Amanda, thank you.
You're unbelievable. I've never met anybody who looks at themselves as much as you do.
I don't look at myself that much, Amanda.
You do, you're obsessed with yourself.
Am I?
Yeah, very. You're very self-obsessed and I don't think you take as much interest in other people as you should do.
I think I do.
No, I don't think you do.
I do.
I think when it comes down to it, it all comes back down to you.
You've just made me sound like I'm an egomaniac.
No, I don't mean it in any bad way. I just think you concentrate on yourself a lot, which isn't such a bad thing, but you do.
We've had some letters or complaints that we're never seen in college and never doing any work. As far as I'm concerned, I know that I do quite a lot of work, but the only reason that you don't see me at college is because film crew don't actually have access into my college because they don't want them in there, and I think that stands for the other departments as well. But we do some work, sometimes.
Do you want a pause there?
Go ahead.
Annika and Mark, our lucky new housemates, arrived to look around and sort out the room arrangements.
You're going
to
come in tonight?
Tonight,
yeah.
And which room are you going to be having?
I don't know, I haven't seen the rooms yet.
Well, I feel like we're a married couple.
What do you think?
So what do you think, dear?
Where's the rat?
The rat's in my room.
Wow.
Welcome to go and play with him whenever it takes your fancy.
The cat
plays with him as well.
Spider.
The cat isn't our cat.
Do you think it'd be possible?
Cat which comes in.
Do you think it'd be possible if I could dissect your rat, maybe? I'm only joking.
Oh, I don't. It's really horrendous.
Did you ever have to do things like dissect rats?
Nope, never.
I mean, I know they do.
I've never dissected a rat ever. But.
Rat.
I have had to see how guinea pig intestine works.
So was it a dead guinea pig anyway?
With no intestine, I would imagine so.
No, I mean, had it died, did you presume it, like, died naturally and then just...
I don't know. I didn't ask questions.
Don't want to get into this, but completely unnecessary.
Yeah. Well, I have a different opinion.
So do I.
And, shut up, you just say anything to a
person. I do have a different opinion,
Annika, it's not necessary,
don't, no, man,
I think some of the experiments which they do are really, really important. But you do humans as well, don't you?
Don't you have to dissect humans?
Yeah, but you don't kill them first.
No.
They die naturally.
I like this boy. He's sharp, he's on the ball.
They die naturally.
Well, this is the lounge.
It's a spider.
It's a spider.
Well, this is Spider's bedroom, which used to be Karen's.
Mm-hmm. Where is that?
Oh, I like gerbils. I like it. Come here, Daphne.
Might be horrible. Just drop it, don't mind.
Let's stick it on the wheel.
Put it on the wheel, yeah, go on.
Oh,
spin it around.
This is Spider's old bedroom. The only thing is that you're right by the front door, so you'll have to answer the door the whole time.
Down here they've got Matt's old bedroom. You know, don't come down here because it smells. Can you smell it? It's horrible, isn't it? Right, this was Simon. This is.
I like this room.
Yeah. What do you want?
I like the upstairs room.
Yeah. I like the downstairs room. Well, sorry.
How lucky.
I'm really sorry.
But no one wants Matt's room.
Mark the medic brought half the rugby team along to help him move in. Wahey! Every Saturday, Matt calls round to the house during his lunch break from Gateway.
Spider, you up? Me.
Still not come down after playing that gig all that night.
How was your ears the next day then?
Fine.
Fine. How's it going at uni then?
It's not going.
Is it that bad?
Completely.
But I mean, it's always your first year. Everyone f***ed up on the first year.
Did they?
Yeah.
Promise.
Yeah, because I swear it is. So, like, first year, just piss it up the wall and hardly ever go in. And then, so, like, second year, more or less do the same.
You still get by, though.
Have you actually got to pass?
Yeah.
All right, I didn't actually know that.
Right.
It's just that temptation to just lie in bed, because, you know, you can do it and exactly. Get away with it. But, you know, you don't get away with it in the long run, because it all comes back to you.
And haunts you.
Yeah.
And my parents are coming today.
Oh, wow. Spider's parents are coming. You ever seen that bit in The Young Ones where Neil's parents are coming round? And they got a mass murderer holding them all at gunpoint and saying, this is even worse than having this happen to us, you know. You could be in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean and get thrown overboard. And then a shark come up to you and say, Neil's parents are coming round for tea, you know what I mean?
At the leisure centre in adjoining gymnasia, Mark and Annika seem to have discovered a very odd way of relaxing.
Six, five, four, three, two, turn it round, twist. Twist. Push it out, come up onto the toes. Up and down and again.
You need a hand tonight?
I've taken some stuff. I'm going to pack up some more stuff. Have you got everything?
Well,
I'll
start moving in last. I'll move the rest of the stuff in tonight. Don't give you a hand, mate.
Right, go and have a beer.
Yeah.
See you later.
See you later.
After Colin gave me an eyeful last week, my mum decided to have words with him.
Colin, I had to come all the way to protect my daughter.
From
the living soap flesher.
Oh, that's right. Do you know, I didn't even get it out. It just looked like I did. And Spider didn't tell you that's true, isn't it?
No, you did.
She's quite safe here with me. Are you younger than Spider?
Yeah, she is.
You look older.
Charming.
Come sitting room.
He's really tall.
Come in. I'll get Bob out in a minute.
That's a bum.
He's in there. Right, if I get him out, you've got to be really, like, still because he gets scared easily.
And he might, I'll let, I could let him run around, but.
Any more conditions?
Bubble, it's mummy. Bubble, granddad and grandma.
Oh my God.
And uncle and auntie.
There he is, can you see him?
Oh my
God. You see him?
He's big.
Look.
He's massive.
Can you see him, Papa?
Yeah, I saw him. All right, leave him alone.
Once Mum and Dad were out the way, I sat down with my brother Jeevan for a chat.
Everyone talks about like having to do essays and stuff. Like, I would do them, I've got time. It's just I don't know that there are any.
You don't have enough time to plan them in advance and that sort
of thing. No, I don't even know of essays which I have to write. And I've kind of been hanging around and...
Well,
it's just, I go to like all these things and then all of a sudden someone on my course is saying, oh my God, have you done that essay? We've got to hand it in. Yeah. And I'm like, A, what essay is this? B, how do you know? And C, when does it have to be handed in anyway?
Right.
It's just like, I feel like I don't know anything. Yeah.
There are loads of people in this position, so like, don't worry about it. Like, don't think you're on your own or anything. And like, you know, if you chat to them about it, you're bound to find that like they feel worried about it as well. But you know, you've got to pass your exams at the end of the year.
But do you think it's too late?
It'll just mean you'll have to do a lot more work now than other people have who've been working steadily.
So I'm just used to doing really well at school, like I did really well all the time, and I just feel now I'm here, I feel like really mediocre.
Maybe that's just because like you haven't been doing much work.
Yeah.
That's what it means, rather than comparing yourself to
other
people.
Yeah, because I don't know how anyone else is doing.
Yeah.
It's just a feeling I get.
I mean, like I found it very difficult to find my feet when I came to university. And I don't know if I have really until the third year.
Did you find it difficult?
Yeah, I find it very difficult. I wouldn't worry too much about it. The only thing you can do is like go and sort it out. It's just a waste of time to worry.
Really. Yeah.
Okay. Take care. Can't you know more on the other?
Okay. And concentrate on your studies. About time too.
Annika packed up her gear and moved into my old room.
Hi.
Are you going to move? Get another bed?
I've got my own. I don't know. I could probably leave it in my house for the time being.
Too much hassle.
Yeah. Is this comfy?
It's very. It's so comfy you can't get up in the morning.
Excellent.
That's my excuse.
Yeah. Okay. I might leave that. I don't. It's going to take me ages. Cheers. I mean,
is this everything now?
Just
what are they?
Like ski boots.
Ski boots.
Yeah.
I have to. Is that what you wear when you ski?
Mm-hmm.
Rollerblades.
Then we'll
see you tomorrow.
Right, thanks for coming in.
I'll give you a hand tomorrow.
Thanks.
Cracking.
See you later.
Colin wasn't the only one in party mood. Little Sammy had a birthday this week. Sammy's dad, Tim, came down to join in the celebrations.
What?
I'm four.
I know you're four.
Crocodile.
Sam, what? I've got a present for you from me and Karen. Oh, well, hey.
Come on, then, put it down. Let's have a look.
Not even Colin's appearance this week on Pebble Mill could distract Sammy.
Colin Rosberg.
When Sammy had gone to bed, we all gathered in the living room to watch a video of Colin's performance.
they pushed me out. I'm on now, and I went. My heart was beating so fast. That was so awful. And half the audience, they were all old age pensioners as well. They like, apparently they bust them in because no one else wants to come and see the show.
That must be why
they never laughed at anything I said.
That was
an easy.
Like, none of your flatmates went to his
they not?
Maybe they don't.
No.
Why not?
None of this lot, no.
Spider might have prearranged to go down to Northampton to go and see some friends. I know she could have done that any time. I said exactly the same
Spider
thing to her.
Is pathetic.
Oh, that's any not fair.
She could have done, yes.
Any
see?
Time.
Cow.
Judging you.
Look, you see? This is what's
going on. That's right.
What difference we see?
Don't you dare say anything awful.
You've got lovely thighs.
You've got a bit of lipstick.
She was really friendly, though.
Yeah, she
really
seems really nice.
Her childhood fantasy come true.
Well, there we go.
Well, at least I wasn't rude.
Yeah.
Because you could, it was live, I could have said
apart
anything.
From calling me a cow.
Yeah. Telling Judith. I called you a cow anyway, Spider, to your face. So it doesn't really matter, does it, budget in front of 1 million people?
So, Annika, who would you have liked to have been the other person?
I mean, all three lads were sound, really. Do you know what I mean? There wasn't anybody you saw and went,
yeah.
You know, oh, my God, really? I mean, what about you? I mean,
I thought the same. I wouldn't have minded any of the six or any of the other five.
Yeah.
How diplomatic.
Yeah.
How unhonest as well.
No, it's true. I mean,
what about Nadia? You went all nice and... give us an eyebrow again. All my friends were like, oh, the doctor who got... Actually, I spoke to somebody else tonight who got in... The Northern Ireland guy, which one was that? The doctor? Oh, lovely! I'm not joking, it was dead funny.
I'm not quite a doctor yet.
Gosh, you two look like you're going to end up shagging. Do you think you will?
That would add some spice to the show.
Yeah. Right, we'll work on Nadia for you.
You don't have to work on Nadia for me, I'm fine.
No, I think it'd be quite nice.
Well, what you think and what happens is different. I'm okay, thank you.
Okay.
But thank you for the offer.
It's okay.
Yeah, that's nice, but... But still, I'll get that.
Get used to it, because...
At least someone gets up and gets things around here.
Oh, shit. So, good show?
Yep.
So, we're alone, Annika, on the sofa.
Your mascara's run, honey.
Has it? Yeah. People think I wear it all the time.
Yeah, you probably do.
There was one more surprise for us. A third new student had been chosen. Nadia.
No, yeah, it's got lots of potential.
It has.
I feel like it's taken.
Yeah, you can't
have any tall friends, is it? I'm only 4 foot 4.
The next day, I decided to sort my life out.
Do you know
out.
Where you're supposed to register for your exams?
Yeah, the exams office.
Do you know where the exams office is?
I went down to university and finally registered for my exams.
Hello.
Can I want to register?
Right, can I have a car?
Dig this. Send my baby to be young.